right, you guys. So let's discuss these power numbers. For those of you who are new here, you just saw me dyno my 2009 BMW 328i xDrive with the N52 engine. And I do have a couple performance upgrades. I did the stage 3 intake manifold swap, and I installed the active AutoWork tune to go with the 3-stage intake manifold swap. So as you guys just saw, this car put out 189 all-wheel horsepower and 184 all-wheel torque. Those numbers are pretty low. They are lower than what I thought the power numbers were going to be. But these are the power numbers according to this dyno that I took it to. I don't know how accurate it is. I'm pretty sure a lot of you are kind of, you know, like disappointed or like kind of confused, you know, like why are the numbers so low? That would include me also because I expected it to be a bit higher. I thought it would be around 210 all-wheel horsepower with the mods I have on. But I guess not according to this dyno. But a couple things here. So as I mentioned, the car is all-wheel drive. So that does have an effect on the horsepower output because there is more power loss as the power is delivered through the drivetrain. And since it is all-wheel drive, that's more power to be lost. Rather than if it was just rear-wheel drive, that's less power that could be lost through the drivetrain. So that is one factor that I'm pretty sure had an effect on the power output. And also when I took the dyno, it was about 91 degrees outside, so it was pretty hot, and that's not really the ideal weather conditions to do a dyno in. If it was a lot cooler, maybe like around 70-60, maybe the power numbers would have been a little bit higher because that's cooler air. And as we know, hotter air does not yield as much horsepower. Also, I kind of have a hunch that my exhaust setup also kind of maybe had an effect on the power output, meaning that I think it caused the car to lose horsepower. If you guys don't know, I have the dual exhaust setup where I just routed two different pipes for two different exits so that it has the dual exhaust look that the 335i's have. But I have a feeling, just, you know, the way the piping is set up on it, I might have lost power because, you know, like the exhaust is supposed to have like back pressure or something like that. I'm not that knowledgeable on it. I just know that you do need some level of back pressure with the exhaust to get, you know, more power. But so that may be another factor on why the numbers were lower than I thought. Maybe if I just had a regular axle back exhaust or the stock muffler, would have been higher. But overall, that is where it should be in terms of power, around 200, give or take 10, plus or minus. If you just have a rear-wheel drive 328i with the same performance mods that I have, I would think you'd be at around maybe 220 rear-wheel horsepower, 230. But again, still nothing significant when you compare power numbers to most of the cars in the car community, modified car community, which I assume a lot of you are in. Just overall, the N52 is just not very tunable. That's just kind of the harsh truth. It is just really hard to squeeze a good amount of power out of this engine unless you just go, you know, full turbocharger or full supercharger. But I don't recommend that because, I mean, that's gonna cost like $5,000 plus. You might as well just get a 335i at that point. But I know a lot of you who follow me also have a 328i with the N52. And a lot of you guys have asked me, you know, how can I get more horsepower? How can I get more power out of my N52? But the truth is that it's just, there's really not much you can do. You can do what I did, which is, if you don't already have it, do the stage 3 intake manifold swap and get a tune with it. I got the active AutoWork tune. If you have the N51 engine, you actually already have the stage 3 intake manifold and you don't have to do a swap, so you can just literally get a tune and you could extract an extra maybe 10 to 20 horsepower. But yeah, that's about it. Regardless of what you do, you won't be making, you know, a lot of horsepower out of this engine. Like I said, it's just very hard to squeeze more power out of this thing, being naturally aspirated. It's much easier if you have a turbocharged car, as you guys have seen if you've been following my F30 content with my 335i with the N55 engine. But yeah, that pretty much summarizes my thoughts and, you know, conclusions here, and my advice for those of you who are, you know, trying to get more power out of your 320Ti. The truth is, just there really isn't that much you can do, unfortunately. If you want more power, my suggestion is to just get a turbocharged car or get a 335i. And I know a lot of people say that. People have told me that, you know, with my modified 320Ti here. Why didn't you just buy a 335i? Well, I didn't know the difference, you know, between a 320Ti and a 335i. So I just worked with what I got, which was the 320Ti with the N52. And I did all this stuff, as you guys have seen and you guys have been following. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys are in the same boat. You guys just didn't know. So don't feel bad. Don't feel discouraged, you know, from modding your 320Ti. I still fully encourage, you know, go do whatever you want with your car. Have fun with it. I still love this car. Power numbers aren't the most important thing to me. Like, I don't really drive fast. I don't race. I don't track the car. So it isn't really that important to me. I know, just depending on what you're doing with your car, it could be important to you. But for me, it's not. So that's why I haven't really been, you know, trying my hardest to get more power out of this engine, because I just don't really feel the need to. And plus, I'm just having fun with my 335i, since that's more tunable. Here's a look at the dyno graph, if you guys want to take a look. If you guys want to pause the video here and just kind of, you know, glance at this. That is the graph with the max power output with two runs. The power curve looks pretty smooth, pretty consistent, better than my F30 when I took that car to the dyno, but I think I fixed that. So yeah, that pretty much summarizes my thoughts and opinions and conclusions here on this stuff. There's not really that much else to say. If I missed something, or if you guys have any questions that I didn't answer, feel free to comment those down below and I will respond with my answer, my opinion, or my whatever. I'll just get back to you. I'll give you some feedback if you still have some unanswered questions, or if you have any other comments or just anything about the dyno or the car or anything. Feel free to comment those down below also. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully I didn't disappoint too many of you with these power numbers. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys were expecting it to be a little bit more, a little bit closer to 200, maybe a little bit above. But that's not the case. Maybe the conditions just weren't right for it to be, you know, for it to yield the most power it can put out. Maybe I'll go back another time when it's cooler outside, and maybe at that point I'll have my axle back exhaust installed on the car, since I am planning to do that also. I am planning to scrap the dual exhaust, like I mentioned in my previous video about my 320Ti here, if you guys have watched that. So yeah, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And subscribe if you're new here for more content like this. Otherwise, I will see you guys in the next video.